Due to a number of people asking me what type of computer I use, you know, to create my videos and to create content, today's video is going to be all about my new, well, to be honest, I need a new computer. That's why I'm showcasing my new computer and not much my old one. Yeah, because it's quite embarrassing when I think about it. So my new 2019 budget 4K video editing machine coming right up. So hey y'all, A-Man here, and you're watching Heart Limits, a channel that talks about everything heart-related. Now, to be honest, this isn't really related with the heart, but... when deciding on what PC to build or to buy, it's very, very important to find out what your needs are, what you're capable of, and what you want to do in the long term. So whenever you use, let's say for instance, Final Cut Pro, and you're not that techie, and you know, you're kind of have this fear of viruses, your safest bet is actually go for a Mac. But if you're looking for a more long-term solution, where you know, you can fix and you can modify your computer to fit your needs, and you edit more on Adobe Premiere, you use After Effects, and you know, all these other softwares, which are usually more complex, it's actually better to go for a PC. So for that reason, I got myself a PC. So let's start unboxing this amazing thing. Now for my PC, I decided to get the Be Quiet Cubase 600 exceptionally silent and functional window. So I decided to get this instead of the NZXT, I think I said that right, NZXT H500, which is either the white or the black, for the reason that almost everyone, for you know, every budget PC build, they always decide to go for this case. So just to be different, I decided to go for the Be Quiet, right? I'm different, yeah, I'm different. So let's open up this box. So here we go. Now to be honest, this is not the best thing to use to open, but whatever, it works. I'm amazed how people can actually open this without having any problems, you know, when they shoot a video. They always have these like unboxing videos. Now would you look at that? Wait. Why is it in this? It's meant to be standing. Oh my god. Okay. How do we do this? So I got this paper from ARTL, so yeah, this is not sponsored or anything, okay? So just so you know, I actually decided to have my computer built with me choosing each and every specific part. And it's mainly because I have this fear and trauma of already building computers. Now, of course, the cheapest way to go is to build your own computer, but there has been so many instances where there was some static in my fingers, or you know, this paste thing that you put on the motherboard just kind of destroys the whole system. If you put little, you know, just too little, or if you put too much, it's just a whole disaster. So for that reason, I decided to just have it built. And the cool thing is, you actually get a warranty. So... and I just got electrocuted by static. So imagine if I built my own computer, I might have just fried the whole thing already, and hopefully I didn't destroy it. That would be really sad. So, let's take a look at this PC, right? Important rule of thumb whenever you are building a PC, especially for video editing, it's very important that you have a powerful processor, and it's important that you have at least 8 cores. And for that reason, I decided to go for the Ryzen 2700X because it has 8 cores and it does more than what I need, and it's pretty affordable in comparison to, you know, to getting an Intel. After deciding on your processor, you're going to have to decide on your motherboard. And for a motherboard that, you know, runs with a Ryzen, it's important that it has this AM4 written on it. And for that reason, I chose the Asus Prime B450 Plus. It's pretty affordable, and cool thing is it has a Type-C, so I can basically plug in, you know, all these other peripherals, like the monitor that I got, for instance, requires a Type-C dongle, and Type-C is awesome if you want to do, you know, fast data transfer. So this is a really good choice, right? Now, RAM, or other people call us memory. It's very important that you keep note that the more RAM you have, the more power and the more, you know, the more fast your computer will be whenever it does certain tasks. And if ever you are working on Adobe Premiere, your base minimum would be at least 16 gigs of RAM, all right? But if you are planning to get into After Effects, it's very important that you have a base of at least 32 gigs of RAM. So for that reason, I actually went for the Corsair Vengeance LPX 32GB. Now, the part that most people love the most is actually the graphics card. But just so you know, the graphics card actually isn't that important when it comes to video editing. You just need a mid-tier one, and it would be already be more than good enough. But of course, if you want to go into gaming, you know, you can invest in more expensive graphics cards. But if you're after a budget video editing machine, somewhere in the middle is actually more than good enough. I actually went for the Gainwar GeForce GTX 1660 Ti Pegasus. And it's an awesome card, which I think you should go for. I know it's really painful, especially if you're a gamer and you know you want to have two in the best of both worlds kind of scenarios. But for you to be able to do so, you're going to have to invest quite a lot of money. So if you're building a PC for video editing, this is all you really need. Now for storage, I actually went for two things. I went for an SSD and an HDD. And the SSD is very important because it really helps your boot time. And I would recommend, and which I actually chose for my machine, I chose the Samsung 970 Evo Plus series, which has the 500GB basically storage space, right? And also I went for, you know, for where I really store almost everything, I went for the Western Digital WD Red 4TB NAS hard disk drive. Now, of course, if you are into so much of video editing, it's actually really important to have a separate drive. And more so if you can, you know, do the cloning system and everything. But for starters, and if you're on a budget, you can start with just one. It's more than good enough, to be honest. And this is a pretty, pretty decent hard disk, and it's an amazing SSD. All right. For the power supply, I went for the Seasonic Focus Plus Gold 650 watts. And to be honest, it's more than what I actually need. Realistically, it's better if you go for a 500 watts. Not really better, but it's more than good enough to go for a 500 watts. But I opted for the 650 watts just in case there are some changes and some modifications that I would want to do in the future. So to make this whole PC with all these components that I actually mentioned, you would only be spending around $1,260. And that's really, really cheap. But of course, I know some of you are quite stingy, you know, stingy. There should be a better word for that. Anyway, I know some of you are quite particular once it goes above the $1,000 mark. So for that reason, I'll be putting down in the description choices and alternatives that you can do so that you can actually get a PC for as low as $920. So let me set up this computer and let me show you how well this PC actually works. So I've set up my PC and it performs amazing. Of course, you might be asking, what screen is this? What is this thing? And why is there like this antenna thing here at the top? Well, what I've actually done is I've also installed, you know, just particular add-ons, which is a wireless LAN card, which has Bluetooth feature, because where I'm living, it's quite hard to actually have a wired connection. This one is actually a soundbar, and I decided to use this particular soundbar. It's actually with the mark LG, the SK1. And it's an awesome soundbar. It has really, really strong bass, and it's perfect for video editing. And the screen I'm using is also an LG. And the model is 27UK850W. And I have to say, it's an amazing monitor. Cool thing is you can really adjust it up and down. You can do the 90 degrees. And there's so much room that you can see everything. And for me, it's a huge difference from what I was working with before. Before, I was just working on a laptop. And for me to do particular, you know, like rendering times and everything, takes me more or less just for a, let's say, how long a video? Let's say an 8-minute video would take me rendering times of about almost an hour. But with this PC, I cut it down maybe like by 4 or 5, depending on how much effects I put. So with this whole setup, I have to say it's just amazing. So once again, Amen here, and you're watching Heart Limits. I want to play more with my computer, so I'm gonna leave you guys, all right? So don't forget to subscribe, hit that like button, and share, all right? So once again, see ya.